The following podcast is brought to you by the 99 Network, New Michigan's premier spot for all your local podcast needs. Winter is here, folks, and it's hitting us with a 1-2 punch. But why stand outside and freeze your ass off when you can call up Chris Lohr from Chris Lohr Lawn Care and Snow Removal? He'll show up at your house and make sure that everything gets cleaned up and salted nicely for you. His number is 989-890-1153. Go ahead and give him a call and drop the 989 Network. Don't know if you'll get a discount, but hey, it makes us look good. Chris Lohr at 989-890-1153.
Warning, this podcast has language of a mature nature. Spencer and Eddie don't know what they are talking about, and in no way should be taken seriously. They are idiots. In fact, this podcast should not be listened or viewed by anyone. But regardless, welcome to the Basement Bar, Beers and Babble. Cheers.
I'm a little up. Dude, I took an 800 milligram fucking Tylenol before I came here.
Yeah?
I don't know why I had such a bad headache. Probably because I got shit for sleep.
Yeah. Go ahead. Give me some words. Stop it. What are you doing? Why would you do that?
He's testing it.
How are we doing, boys?
The percussive. That's the best out of all the mics. Why would you disgrace it like that?
That was funny.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Happy to be here, boys.
Mm-hmm. I can hear him.
Yeah. Good.
All right.
Cool.
Hold on one second.
I just don't like it. All right, I guess you're buying a new one at that point.
How was the John Jones fight?
It was all right.
Did it any KO? I couldn't see anything. I tried to look it up.
Jones did knock him out.
He did?
Yep. He finished the job. Damn. Hit him with a hell of a heel kick right to the liver, and Stipe was dead.
Really? Yeah. Damn.
My man crumbled.
My man crumbled.
Holds on to the championship then.
We'll see if he defends it.
Yep.
What was that? Well, in 4 years. MMA?
UFC.
UFC stuff? Okay.
MMA, yeah.
Heck yeah.
Mixed martial arts. Are we fucking back? Are we live?
Holy shit. Welcome back to Basement Bar, Beers, and Babble. I got to tell you, this is a first for us, and I don't hate it. It is Sunday morning.
Yeah. It's a first. Yeah.
Praise Jesus. It's Sunday morning. We're fucking hanging out here.
Yep.
We've got Raj starting out in the studio. That's amazing. That isn't...
That was wild. That took forever, dude.
Yeah.
How's your fingers feeling? It is early, huh?
Your age
he had no strength on that one.
His age is showing.
Damn.
Hey.
No, we're excited. Yeah. We have a first-time guest, and I think it's the first time he's ever held a microphone in his life. We got fucking Derek Lupo in the studio, huh?
Yeah, all the way from St. Charles, from the man down under here, we've got motherfucking Derek Lupo.
Hell yeah.
How we doing, boys? Happy to be here.
Yeah, we are hot.
Yeah, it is hot down here, actually.
No.
I was like, it is fucking, it's a little hot down here, isn't it? Jesus Christ.
I thought I had everything set right. It's coming probably out. Didn't.
Do you need anything to drink? You want to... The twisted tea?
I'm all good right now, my friend.
He's like, it's fucking 11 o'clock.
How
weird are you guys?
Yeah, we're very weird.
We got the Lions game later today.
Ooh,
super excited about
it. Yeah, that'll be fun.
Yep. Going to go get some good eats. We don't know where we're going yet, but fucking have Jahmyr Gibbs and David Montgomery tear it up a little bit today. Hoping so, since Sam Laporta's out. Fucking bullshit.
I'll take about five less interceptions from Goff this game.
I think it'll happen.
Can I get a little less suck out of the football, please?
Well, that's all I'm saying. They didn't show up off the bus last time.
But they still won.
They did still
win.
Still
won the game, so we'll take it.
That's what I'm saying. We just need the Chiefs to lose so the Detroit Lions could become number one in the league. It pisses me off that the Chiefs are still number one. The refs are probably the best teammate. Yeah.
They've been helping them all season.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. There's nothing I could say about the Ravens, but... That he did step out, but I wanted the Ravens to win that game so bad.
Sorry, I'm just over here.
I know you're fucking
shit.
With some shit. That's all right. So we had some recent events happen in the world.
Oh yeah, recently. Yeah. We haven't talked in a while here. It was I think the last time we met was right before the election.
Yeah.
And so we had an election. That was fun. I got to vote early, which I never like wanted to or cared to before. But you know, I'm getting older and I'm busy, and I was like, fuck, I can go on Saturday. I don't have to wake up at the ass crack of dawn. Like, all right, sounds great.
I know John, who's been on this podcast quite a bit, he was like, you know, if I ever became president, I would get rid of the early voting, like straight out, flat out. Like, if you want to vote, you're going to make an event out of it. You're going to get your ass there, and you're going to fucking vote.
Well, yeah. At that point, you put it a national holiday where everybody... Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Like, if you know, you could go when you can need to go, and it's... Yeah, that I like that. That'd be nice.
But I still worked, and I was still able to make it at 7 o'clock, you know?
Yep.
But then I chased around. I went to one place, and they were like, oh, you need to go down here. And then I went to that place, and they were like, you actually need to go across the street. And I walked in. I was bitching so fucking tough to John on the phone. I was like, Christ, I'm glad I didn't go to a fucking pumpkin patch. Like, I'm already walking through a fucking maze already just to get to where I have to, you know, bubble a few things on a fucking piece of paper. It was stupid. It was stupid. They were like, what sector are you, or what sanction, or whatever the fuck they call it? And I was like, I don't know. This is where I live. I want to fucking vote, and I want to go home. I'm hungry. You know, but it worked out.
Yeah.
I got my shit done, and yeah, that happened.
Yeah, yeah, it wasn't bad. I like all the cool stickers they had this time. They had like a contest fish. Or something, yep. I guess.
That, oh, really?
Like, kids drew the stickers. Everybody, the werewolf one is actually like selling for money online. People are buying those up.
I have a cool Michigan fucking, like a rainbow trout one.
Oh, there you go.
Hope I voted. Yeah,
yeah, cool. Yeah. Yeah. Mm. I got the stick figure one. That was like, I'm cool. I voted.
That's funny.
Yeah.
I didn't grab one.
Oh, why? You didn't?
No. Why?
It's a sticker.
Too cool for sticker. The stickers?
Wow.
I don't need unbelievable. A sticker.
Never give this man a sticker, Dave.
Wasn't like, feeling like a kid in the doctor.
Yeah. That's checking out. Did you get the lollipop, though?
That's what I wanted. Boy, I want the sucker. I don't want a sticker. I want a sucker.
That's what she said.
I just tried to smoke my microphone. It didn't work well. Mm. I licked it on accident.
All right. So in this podcast, we normally... Is there more recent events you want to talk about, or can I move on?
No. Well, there was another one, but we'll get to it later.
Okay.
Yeah, all right, yeah.
Good. All right. So in this podcast, we do a thing called like what you've been listening to, what you've been watching. We're actually going to start out with Mr. Lupo over here.
Yeah.
What you've been listening to, man?
Or watching. What do you
got? Recently... I know it's about probably 6 years too late at this point, but we just finished Better Call Saul.
And oh, there you
show.
Go.
That is a good show.
That is top three shows I've ever watched in my life.
I have not finished it yet, but you put me onto it.
I'm not going to lie. It is a good one. It leaves you on the edge of your seat.
Yeah.
Oh, I think I watched that when I was a teenager.
Tell me about it. I know. I knew I was late to the party. It's like I just watched The Gladiators for the first time or something.
That's funny. You've also watched Breaking Bad, too, a couple of times, haven't you? Oh,
absolutely. Mm. I've only finished it once, and that was also in the last year.
It was?
So, very late to that one as well. But that one rocked my socks off. I'm not going
to lie. I couldn't make it to the good parts. I thought it was too boring in the beginning, and I shut it off.
You got
to
push through, man.
That's what
I
hear.
I'm telling you this. The storyline in that show is top tier.
Is it?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
I should get into it. Other than watching, what you've been listening to? I know you went to a few concerts recently. What were those?
Well, recently I've seen Kid Laroi, which is probably one of my favorite artists right now. He's like I would say he's past up and coming. He's a bigger, like, he kind of classifies as a rapper, but he also is like R&B type feel to it. It's just like, you know, I would say more pop than R&B actually.
Gotcha.
But, he's really good. Two or three weekends ago. We went and saw Vince Staples.
That
would
have
been Friday night, and then we saw Mexican OT on Saturday. Both shows were amazing.
I love Mexican Overtime.
Yeah. No, but both of those shows were great. Outside of that, just kind of...
It's much better than their standoffs.
Yeah, no, you got that right.
Jesus Christ, that's funny. Yeah.
No,
oh,
but,
that's cool.
You know,
yeah.
It's been a lot of rap, honestly.
Yeah.
That's kind of the top of the...
Mm.
Top of the list.
Yeah, I'm jealous about the Vince Staples one, man. Holy shit.
That was a cool one to see.
Mm-hmm. And where did you see that at? Where was that at?
That one was at,
it was in Detroit, right? Or was it?
Yeah, it was like an opera hall. It was honestly a...
The Fillmore?
No, it was a venue I've never been to, and I've been to a lot of concerts in Detroit.
The Blind Pig. No.
No, that's Ann Arbor.
No, I cannot remember it.
There's the magic bag,
head,
the magic stick.
It's Detroit adjacent, I guess.
Yeah. There's L Club. Yeah, there's a lot of places in Detroit that's fun. Or near Detroit, anyway. Hamtramck. Yeah.
It was definitely an interesting spot, but the show was cool. Show was cool.
When he pulls up in an opera hall, and then it's Vince Staples.
No, literally.
You're like, oh, weird setting.
Okay, all right.
That was a trivia word I was trying to think of the other day. Hamtramck.
Yeah.
And you just, I was like, fuck. I was like, Samsonite. Like,
yeah,
that was
fucking... way off. Yeah. That's funny. Raj, what you been watching recently?
Just all the... Well, we finished up all the Yellowstone.
Jesus
stuff.
Christ, man. Those are long episodes, and you
and
whipped through
back.
That shit.
Oh, yeah.
I'm so excited.
It is back.
Yep. In fact, tonight,
Yeah. Oh,
another episode. You were fucking hype, 8 o'clock. Aren't you?
Well, yeah, because
he's a big Yellowstone guy.
You know, now it's like I gotta wait a week.
Oh,
so,
I know.
And you know your mom, so now it's like 6 nights of fucking Hallmark Christmas shit.
Yep.
Oh, you love Hallmark, and then, Hallmark Christmas
then I
movies.
Get to watch
are you kidding
what I
me?
Want to.
You have socks that say if you can read this, I'm watching it, or shut up, I'm watching a Hallmark Christmas movie. You fuck with them so tough. Don't even lie. Don't even lie. That's a ritual for you. You're like, as soon as Christmas time comes on, you're like, yeah, I want to watch the most predictable Christmas movie ever.
Well, they're all predictable. Yeah, you know what happens in all of them.
Exactly. Yeah. She's going to come home. She's going to see a lover that she used to have, and then they're going to rekindle their love. That happens every time.
Pretty much. Yeah.
That's it. That's exactly.
Sometimes I get a dog.
Yep. See, I would think if it was funny if like this person was just was like miserable and they came home and then they met somebody and then it happened again and they're just miserable at the end of the movie. I think it'd be awesome. Like a horror Hallmark movie. Come on. It'd be funny.
Yeah. A little Shyamalan twist at the
yeah,
end.
Yeah, yeah. Just like, actually, no, fuck you. You're a bitch. You know, I don't know. I think it'd be funny. Merry Christmas, though. You know, and then she gets cold. That'd be hilarious.
Merry Christmas. I just used you. So
yeah. Yeah, I got to go back to New York, so fuck you.
Go back to my fiance.
Yeah. Damn.
I read the saddest thing on Facebook the other day. It said, if you were born before 1989, you are now older than Marv was in Home Alone. And I was like, son of a bitch.
Oh, you old motherfucker.
Getting fucking old.
Damn. That's actually funny.
Yeah.
But if you were born, now you're older than Marv was? Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I was just about to say, wouldn't you have always been older?
No, that's Raj.
Oh, okay. Oh, damn.
Oh, boy.
Damn. Dude, he's punching up right now. He's punching up.
Wow.
That was crazy.
We had such a nice day the other day. I had to. Sorry, you.
Last time we were talking about Outer Banks and how I was waiting for the second part of the fourth season to come out.
Oh, yeah.
Well, it did, and I finished it in 2 nights.
Good.
Show sucks.
And no.
Show sucks.
Fuck you. Fuck you for that.
Oh, fuck
it's
you.
Such a good one.
I got what, through is, the first, what is this Outer Banks about?
I got the through the first season. I'm like, this
about
is
children.
Fun. Dude, it's so stupid. Good. Okay, no, it's so good. And you know what? The end of season four made me cry, all right? But here's the deal. Outer Banks is really a treasure hunting adventure about these six kids from the Outer Banks. And they
Carolina, North Carolina, they, South, or wherever.
Yeah, and they track down a treasure in the first three seasons, and then it kind of keeps going a little bit.
Okay.
They're only expected to do season five and then be done if the story's over.
I got
but
you.
It's super good, and there's, you know, a lot of different characters. Well, six main ones, and then, you know, there's characters that come in and out of it or whatever, but I'm just attached to it. I like the thrill of the hunt type of deal.
Yeah.
And that's kind of what it is, and it's super good, and it's about kids our age. You
sounds
know?
Like a Goonies type knockoff.
Kind of, yeah. No, it, why is it stupid?
Is there a sloth? Is there a sloth?
No, there is not.
So it's
no.
It's worse.
It's real. It's like realistic.
It's
you
like
know
the
what I'm
Kmart
saying?
Version of
yeah.
Goonies.
Okay,
but it's kind of it's almost like West Side Story too, because you got you know your Jets and your Sharks. You got the
Kooks so
and the Pogues. No,
it would be if it were a musical. I'd like it better. Yeah.
I feel like they could turn it into a musical. It's really good, but no, it's I think it's fun. So I just finished that. And then I've been listening to, this is weird, but I've been digging into some 50 Cent a lot.
Oh.
Yeah, there you go, little Curtis Jackson.
Yeah, yeah. It'll be fucking 6 o'clock in the morning when I start my venture to work, and I'll be blasting into club
nice.
For no reason. But I have to do it going into Saginaw. It just feels right. You know what I'm saying? So like downtown Saginaw, just, you know, I don't know. It's fun. So, yeah, a lot of 50 Cent going on. A lot of 50 Cent going on. So other than that, that's about it. What about you, Eddie?
Oh, I've been listening to a lot of polka. Ish is die Dritten.
I'm sorry, but I hate polka music, dude.
Do you really? Oh, because I was going to give you a little like.
You can. Yeah, rolling on the barrel. Yeah.
Well, fuck, and dude, yeah, so Christ. this I like. These
fuck guys. It.
What the hell? They forget the words?
That sounds like that sounds like that Katie Taylor on Friday.
Yeah, no, honestly.
It builds. It's really cool.
That's my last three brain cells playing for my life at the end of a Friday night. I'm not going to lie to you, Doug.
Yeah. I like it, man. It's some good shit, man.
People listen to this in their car, you just cause like major accidents.
Oh,
100%.
I do. Like, dude, I play it with the windows down. It's great.
Well, you're trying to do the fucking, what do they call it? Two-step or the three-step or whatever the fuck they call it.
I don't know if you're stepping to that one.
Yeah. No, I like it, man. It's good. It's good shit.
That's wild. I don't know. I don't like polka music. I don't know why.
No?
No.
I like
it. That was kind of fire.
I like polka.
I'm not going to blast that, you know? That's why I don't listen to your Spotify playlist anymore, because that shit will pop on. I'm like, what the fuck is that?
You're like half Polish, yeah. And you don't like Polish music?
I'm just saying, like, if I pull up to a beer tent at Munger and the polka's going on, I'm like, yeah, I get fucking down to it. Just give me a beer.
I think the setting has to be right.
I
couldn't imagine just sitting down and casually listening.
Yeah,
you know, you got St. Stan's. It's all polka.
That's why I don't go to St. Stan's. It also smells like fucking piss and cheeseburgers there all the time. So,
well,
piss and cheeseburgers.
That's what it does. Have you ever been?
That is kind of 50% of the mass of objects in that area.
It's all beer and brats, man. So, I mean, yeah.
As a man that grew up in Bay City, he does not respect Bay City.
Absolutely not.
It's a Polish sausage and sauerkraut thing.
Why does it smell like cheeseburgers and shame? And
yeah. It's kind of funny, actually, if you look at these two fuckers right here, because they did a total flop. So Raj kind of grew up where you live now, mm-hmm. and you grew up where he kind of lives now.
Absolutely.
And then you guys hit that flip at, like, basically the same time. Like, you're getting married. Mm-hmm. He did it when he got married type of deal.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like one and the same. I don't know. It's kind of funny.
Excuse me.
It's kind of funny to think that way. Because he's out there in the St. Charles area.
Well, I was in Saginaw Township.
I know you were in Saginaw Township, but he basically is in Saginaw. I would call it Saginaw Township.
I think I'm technically in the township.
Yeah.
It kind of crosses waters every once in a while.
You're not in St. Charles.
I'm not in St. Charles, but I've been told I'm not in Saginaw.
I feel like I can get to
Gratiot. No, I wouldn't. Not in Saginaw. No, I don't even know if it'd be a suburb. It's like an outburb.
I'm kind of just like a little outsider, baby.
But you have the Pines. You have the Pines disc golf course, man. I fucking love that.
Super close to him.
Yeah.
And then what was that?
Is that the one we went to the one time?
There's a golf course that has a fucking, what was it called?
The Twilight Special?
Yeah, Twilight Special. We paid $20.
Yep.
To play as many holes as you can.
Until sundown. Yep.
And
it comes with a cart.
Yeah, it comes with a cart.
Yep. It's nice.
$20. And it actually was a really nice course. Fucking difficult.
A lot of water. So you're really testing yourself up there. But it's a cool experience.
And the greens are no shit a fucking pool table. Pool table. They are so fast.
Yeah.
We couldn't, like, we would hit nice shots that hit the green, but they would still be 50 yards off the green when we got up there because they would roll that fast off.
Oh,
they
don't
slow down one
you
hit.
Hate it.
It was crazy. It bounced like fucking ping pong. And it was middle of the summer. There was nothing wrong.
So you got to hit like 10 yards in front of the green for it to roll up.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And then when it rolls up, you're probably still rolling off the green, but at least you'd be on the fringe. It was stupid. I don't know how to play that.
All of them shaped were, you know. Were
like
all,
a dome?
Yeah, like a dome. So they just fucking.
Kind of. There was a pristine course, really.
You beat that, right?
What?
You just put it in the fucking cup.
Yeah, God, how do you
spin?
You know what? I'll try that next time.
I'll try it.
I feel like I tried every time. It just hasn't worked, but let me do that next time for you.
Work for me once.
All right, well, now we can fucking move on to our guest here.
Yeah, holy fuck. I am very, very excited. So Spencer has had the pleasure of spending a great deal amount of time with this individual, and I have not so much. So I'm very happy for you to be here. I'm excited to drill down and learn into who is Mr. Lupo. Take it away, sir. Tell us about yourself. Where do you come from? Where do you go? Where do you come from? Cotton Eye Joe.
All right, let's see here. First off, I want to just say I'm happy to be here. Appreciate you guys. Well, let's just start with where we were born. So my name is Derek. I was born here in Bay City, lived here till I was 18 or 19, went to school at Garber. Didn't love it. It was good enough. You know, I can't complain. Met some good people. That was easily the best part. Also met some questionable people, but you know, they're not around anymore. Kind of been in and out of college, been focusing a lot on my career. So I work at High Life Farms, been there for about 5.5 years now, something like that.
One of the oldest there. Swear to God.
Yep.
Nice.
Top 10 in tenure.
So, you know, pushing for that number one spot eventually. Yeah. But the worst part about that is to get to the number one spot.
You got
to
kick out your best friend.
No, that's the thing. I need a few people that I actually really like to leave. Yeah. So it's like a double-edged sword there. I'll be happy with the top 10. So been there for about 5.5 years, getting married to my fiance upcoming.
Oh, congratulations.
Well, thank you very much. Next May, actually.
5/25/25.
So need to get a good date.
Perfect date.
Yeah, we need to get our shit together, though, because I've been kind of just leaning back like, we got a few months. And now
It's crunch
time.
We're
down to about 6 months, and we definitely need to get the pedal to the floor. So it's kind of top priority right now. You know,
you got to tell your engagement story. It's fucking awesome.
The engagement story. All right. Well, let's go back a little bit here. So it was probably about a year and a half ago, right around there. I took my lovely fiance, girlfriend at the time, on a cruise. You know, we went on a Carnival cruise down to, we hit Mexico, we hit Grand Cayman, and we hit, that must have been one of the long stops. I'm not gonna lie. I was probably
sitting at that time of the cruise, I wasn't drunk.
Yeah, no, exactly. I was sitting in the bar a little bit too long on that one, so I can't remember what that stop was, but I can tell you this, it was beautiful. But long story short, so if you've ever been on a Carnival cruise, they have comedians on the show or on the boat, normally two or three of them. So that's been one of our favorite things to do when we go on the cruises, is go to the comedy shows.
Oh, of course.
You just get drunk. You sit in you laugh your ass off for 45 minutes, an hour, whatever their set is.
Yeah.
And then you go you'd go drink more.
Yeah.
But anyways, we go there the first night that the show's open, and we see a guy. His name's Gene Harding. And this dude is arguably one of the funniest comedians I've ever seen in my life.
Hell yeah.
And he's like they're not going to get, you know, the George Lopez's, the, you know, the Tom Segura's. They're not going to get those guys. So these are like C-list comedians. Mm-hmm. But I'll tell you this, he can stand toe-to-toe with them.
Really?
He had us dying the first night. The next day, you know, obviously you're on a ship. There's not too many places to go. You're going to run into these people eventually. So we're sitting out at the bar, and I look over, and it's the comedian from last night. And I was like, oh, this is kind of cool. You know, he's just out here intermingling with everybody. So I start kind of just shooting the shit with him, talking.
They're like people.
No. They're actually real. So we're just shooting the shit, you know. One thing leads to another. We actually, you know, strike up a cool little friendship. So we've been seeing each other every day on the boat. We have one stop in Mexico, and me and my girlfriend at the time, we're out there on the port, and there's this guy that has two parrots that he just kind of like does like pictures, and you know, he does like a whole show. So he pulls us in. We're like, all right, cool, you know, we'll give it a shot. So we're up there, and we're standing there with the parrots, and like he's making it do like different cool stuff, like hanging from our fingers. Letting it sit on our shoulders, all that sort of stuff.
Oh, so like little parrots.
This was like a...
Oh, is it a macaw?
Giant parrot. Oh, shit. So it's like one of the moves, you know, you put your finger out, and then he has the bird grab onto your finger with its beak, and then he just lets go of it, and it's just hanging from your finger. And it's just chilling. Yeah. Like, this thing has not a care in the world.
That's wild. So like, those birds can snap broomsticks with their fucking beaks.
Yeah, I was nervous. I'm not gonna lie. I was nervous.
There's a lot of liquid courage into that one.
It's a big-ass bird. And then you got two of them.
Oh, yeah.
Now there's two on your shoulders, and you're like, all right, smiling for the camera here.
Right? Yeah.
So we're sitting there.
I wonder what that guy's insurance has to be with the fucking. Sorry.
My bird kills somebody. How much?
Yeah, really.
I'm gonna tell you. We're
Mike Tyson somebody's ear.
We are outside of Port Authority in Mexico. I don't think there was insurance.
It's international.
I think if something happens, he's gone and I'm cooked. Yep.
Flopping on the pier like a fish.
So we're sitting there. We're getting the pictures. And this guy walks up, like just randomly walking up as we're doing it, and he starts saying something. And he's wearing a ball cap, and he's got sunglasses on. And like he basically was like, you know, you guys want me to take a picture of you or whatever? And Bailey gets extremely standoffish. So she's not a huge fan of random people, strangers, as you would say. So this guy walks up, and he's like, hey, you guys want a picture? She gets extremely standoffish. She's like, no. And he's like, oh, all right, you know, walks away. I notice as he's walking away, this is the comedian from the show that we've been making a friend with. This is Gene. This is Gene trying to talk to us. And she just completely disrespected my man. She was like, get the fuck. Like, basically, like, get out of here. Like, you, like,
yeah.
Like, didn't
shoot,
obviously
vagrant.
Say that, but she was very cold, very standoffish. And he starts walking away, like, just like, all right, whatever, fuck you. And I turn around and I said, wait, Gene. Like, I'm yelling at him. I'm like, is that you? Like, Gene. He turns around, he takes his sunglasses off. Bailey's embarrassed as hell now because she's like, oh my God, I'm so sorry. I didn't know it was you.
That's funny.
So this happens. And then it just kind of makes us closer. You know, at that point, we're like, hey, you know, let's go get a bite to eat. We go to the restaurant down the road. We just sit down, you know, shoot the shit for an hour and a half, have some nice, you know, nachos and margaritas, you know, mm-hmm. the typical. And then as we're kind of talking, I think Bailey goes to the bathroom or something like that. And I bring it up to Gene because I was like, listen, you know, I got my girlfriend here. You know, we have been together for a long time now. I do have a plan in the back of my head to get engaged. You know, is there any way you could, you know, maybe help me out? Because I think it would be really cool if I could do it on stage.
Right.
Hell yeah.
So he kind of agrees to it. We're so I get his phone number and I'm texting him like throughout the upcoming days because we only have, I think, like 2 or 3 chances left at this point in terms of like shows to actually do it. So like any chance I get that I'm away from Bailey or like I'm turned away or whatever, I'm on my phone. I'm like, you know, cooking it up with this guy to try to get a plan. And then next thing you know, it's the day we've got it set in. Woke up at 5 a.m. I'm already texting before she gets out of bed.
Scared as shit.
So it's like, you know, we got everything planned. And so we know it's going to be at like the 8 o'clock show or whatever it is. We go to the show that night. I had told, we made friends with a couple on the boat. So I told them, you know, hey, you know, I got this going on. I've already talked to Gene. I will be proposing tonight. Can you guys please be there? Because I wanted somebody to be able to record the, immortalize this. Because mm-hmm. this is, I'm not going to be able to record this. I'm going to be fucking on
stage. Yeah.
So I begged them to come and they were like, oh, absolutely. We want to be there. So we show up to the comedy show an hour early.
Dude, hey, at least you were prepared, listen, dude. You were like, we cannot miss it. We gonna get our good seats.
That was it. I had to get the seats. And like I said, this was a funny comedian. So it's like people were already starting to build up hype. So it's like people were starting to show up 20-30 minutes early.
Yeah.
I'm nervous as hell. This is one of the biggest moments of my life. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, all right, Bailey, the show starts at 8 o'clock. You know, let's just go to the comedy hall, you know, at 7 o'clock.
Yeah.
Let's sit in our chairs for an hour by ourselves in this empty fucking room and let's have some drinks. I don't know how she didn't catch on to that something was going on because I shit you. Wait, I mean, we sat there for 40 minutes, just me and her in a room.
You're sweating your ass off.
I'm nervous as hell. I'm downing drinks. We get closer to the showtime. So it's probably like 7:55 at this point, you know, show starts at 8. I'm sitting there. It's still just us two at our table. And I'm like, my friends they're going to fuck me over. Yeah. Like, I'm not going to be able to get this on camera. I'm going to get pulled up. It'll still be a cool moment, but, you know, I won't be able to show anybody or, you know, have that memory, you know, in a video format or whatever. So I'm getting nervous as hell. Even more so. I'm about to ask my girlfriend to marry me. Mm. And now the plan that I have in place is falling apart in front of my eyes.
Oh, no.
So I'm sitting there and the whole time, like, this is like 20 minutes to the show. For that whole entire 20 minutes, I'm sitting around, I'm pacing, I'm turning my head, I'm looking, I'm like, where the fuck are they? Yeah. Where are they? Finally, the show starts, and they're still not there. And I was like, all right, I'm cooked. I'm just going to have to go just straight, you know,
rip everything it. Is like, you feel like you're going downhill.
Yeah, right? So I got to rip it. So I'm like, whatever, you know, it is what it is. It's probably like 8:03, 8:04, show's already started and going. I turn around, and I see them like scurry in. And then they sit at like the back. Like they don't even like, because we're sitting like right in front of the stage.
Yeah.
They sit like in the back and I'm like, oh no. Like I turn around, I look at them. I'm like, get over here, you know? They don't see me. So I have to get up and literally like basically run over, grab them and like bring them in.
Yeah.
So finally get them in, whatever, you know? We're watching the show. Gene kind of leads into it really cleverly. Like to not make it seem like something weird was happening.
Yeah.
Because basically what he was been doing the whole time throughout all these shows is he's meeting people and he's telling stories about the people that he met on the boat. So he's bringing in people that he's like been encountering and, you know, talking about it and all that. So he starts talking about me. He calls me up on stage and Bailey's sitting there like, oh, this is so cool. You know, like you're getting called up. And so I get called up. I'm up there on the stage and he starts talking about us a little bit. And then he calls her up too. And now she's nervous as fuck.
Yeah.
But still, she has no idea what's actually about to happen. She, in her mind, thinks that he's just going to tell jokes about us.
About you too. Yeah.
And he was probably, like, obviously the Mexico thing had just happened.
Yeah.
Where it was like, so she completely like, disrespected. Yeah. He starts talking about that. So she's like,
fuck.
No, she's like, I'm getting cooked right now for no reason. And then he just kind of like slowly leads into it. And he's like, all right, you know, I think Derek might have something to say. And at that point, I dropped down to my knee. You know, I got he's got the mic in my face.
Did you hear, like, the audible
yeah.
from the whole crowd?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, and I also heard my voice crack.
That is fact. In the video, it is so fact.
About three fucking times. I'm saying it in my head before I say it, and I'm like, oh, I sound so good right now.
Yeah.
You know, my voice is hitting. I sound like a real man right now. You know, I'm about to ask my fucking woman to marry me for the rest of my life.
Yeah.
Hey, Nicole, you know what I mean? Couldn't have sounded more fucking pathetic. I shit you not.
Hey, listen,
but
it was
long story short, it went beautifully. It was a very cool moment. She was really happy. You know, the crowd was filled with people. They were all, you know, cheering and laughing and everything, and everyone was saying congratulations after. It was a very cool moment, but yeah, embarrassed the hell out of myself. And hey, thank God I got the video of it.
Yeah,
so I'll remember that voice crack for the rest of my life now. You know, thank God.
I love it.
That's funny.
Oh, that's great.
Well, fucking ain't right. So now you're engaged.
Yeah.
Now you're in St. Charles. You have a great fucking career going for you right now.
Yeah. Aren't you like his fucking boss or something?
I kind of am.
If he tells me to jump, I say how high. Yep. Shit.
You know not quite as nice though. There's a lot of attitude there, but he will jump eventually.
Yeah, no, I do have that attitude on me. I do. But also, I don't get the atmosphere that they have.
No, it's fair. Right?
And I'm working my ass off towards that, but I'm not there yet. You know what I mean? So
gotcha.
So everybody's got to start somewhere. But I do owe everything that I have right now to this guy because it is true. I took the job opportunity that he has offered me on the third attempt that he asked me.
Oh shit!
And now look where I am in my life.
I knew what I wanted early, man.
I understand, but you need to understand where I was and now where I am. I'm so much better off, and it was because I took that opportunity. I just wonder where I would have been if I took it on the first one. Probably not where I am today, but. Everything happens for a reason. You know what I'm
saying?
But absolutely. I do. I do owe a lot.
I firmly believe in that one right there.
Yep. I do owe a lot to Derek, and that's why he is one of my best friends. So I can respect the fuck out of this man. I really do.
I love you, brother.
I really do. I love you too, man.
Hell yeah.
Good shit. And I do just want to add this before we get into the old lovely sip of the brewski.
Yeah.
He went to Traverse City. Correct me if I'm wrong. No.
This was in Charlevoix. It was kind of right outside Charlevoix. It was like a little like family farm out there. Okay. But they have so many. By the dime a dozen up there in northern Michigan. There's so many different like orchards and cideries and all that. But outside of Charlevoix for this one.
He went there and he actually tried a fucking cider. That's the closest thing to a beer that he's ever enjoyed in his life.
That I enjoy. So proud of him. Yes. Very surprising. So very surprising. I'm not going to lie.
You're going to love our beer of the week. It's some good shit.
Hopefully. Are we about ready to get into it?
Yeah. Beer of the week.
Beer of the week.
Whoop.
Beer.
I'd have a beer.
Beer of the week.
Beer of the week.
Beer of the week.
All right.
Here we go, baby. We're live now.
Beer of the week is Slamnesia from Austin Brothers Beer Co. in Alpena, Michigan. It is an 11.4% triple IPA. Now, this is a special one. It is brewed annually in celebration of their anniversary. Slamnesia is an unfiltered triple IPA, double dry hopped with all mosaic hops, giving strong mango, peach, and tropical fruit notes. Noticeably drinkable, almost sessionable. Cheers.
All right, cheers.
All right, cheers, boys.
Cheers, cheers.
Okay.
That's wild. That's actually wild.
Ooh.
Why do I get barbecue off of that? That's weird.
Right?
That's weird.
So did I.
Yeah.
It's almost like a Lay's barbecue chip.
Nah, I don't know about it.
I got to go back for another. Hang on.
I think that's mixing
with the bush.
They're saying that's they're supposed mango to be like mango. And
I'm not getting the fruit.
I'm not getting the fruit.
I got the mango. And I don't like
actually,
mango.
I'm getting not the fruit itself, almost like the peel of the fruit. Yeah. You know?
Well, that's probably what they fucking put
in
there.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm not the biggest fan. Chewing I don't think skin. It's bad.
I don't think I would drink an entire one, but I'm not upset with the drinks I've had.
It literally tastes like a barbecued kettle chip.
Yeah,
that's fucking wild.
So let me explain the rating system to Derek.
0.25.
Really
okay.
It's out of five, but you can do quarters.
Okay.
So he's going 0.25. I'm going to give it a 1.5.
I give this guy a 4.
Really?
I'm going to give it a 4. I fucking love barbecue chips.
Where I put a 4 is I could have a pint or two of that.
Well, yeah.
I can't.
I can have two Triodos without coming up to say hello.
Fuck that, dude.
Jeez. Let me take one more drink of this, and then I'll give my honest rating here.
Okay.
Just the smell got me.
Okay, the more I drink it, the more I don't like it.
Yeah.
I'm going to... Oh, really? I think I'm going to give that one a 0.75.
Wow.
Yeah.
No. Well.
Yeah, that's not fucking bad.
Yeah, 1.25 or 1.5 for me. That's about it.
Thank you so much to Ideal Party Store, where all the fancy beers can be found.
That's where the 1.25 comes from, is the seller. Other than that.
But I also need to give a special shout-out to one of our listeners, who I'm coming out of Ideal with the beer in the week in my hand, and I see this gentleman walk up, and he goes, holy fuck! He's like, beers in Babel! And Aaron Wiley, phenomenal human being, real great guy, devout listener of the show. He'll text me and gets angry when we don't put something out fast enough. he's a great guy.
That's awesome.
But yeah, he saw me as I was walking out. He's like, oh fuck, is that the beer of the week? I said, yeah. He's like, I'm the first to know the beer of the week.
Damn.
That's awesome, he was so dude. Excited.
That's
yeah.
really cool.
So yeah, thanks Aaron for listening.
Yeah, Aaron, shout out Aaron, we appreciate that's awesome, you. Man.
Fuck yeah. Well, we tried it, Aaron, and it sucked, but
I loved it. No, just I'm like just I love all of you.
Oh, yes. Oh, I also love everybody.
Beer of the week.
Yeah, I was just about to say, how's your throat feel? Knees bruised? What are you doing?
Yep. So then comes, I got a little story to tell you about.
Oh, there
I
we
love
go.
This.
About years ago, back in high school.
I have herpes.
And
what?
Do you see that? What is that on my finger?
The fuck?
Herpes.
Yeah, that is fucking herpes. Sorry,
wild.
Continue.
That's wild. Stop itching right there. Fucking disinfect it. Raj, did you get rid of the disinfectant?
It's down there.
Oh, shit, the beer gave me finger herpes. Never mind, it's a 1.25.
Yeah, fuck it. I love Lay's chips. No, anyway.
And no offense, like to Bailey. Bailey's blonde, right?
Kind of. More brunette, but yeah, it has a little hint of it.
The girl I dated was blonde in high school, and I remember one Saturday morning, I get a phone call from her, and she's all distressed and like, I need help. You need to come over here, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, what's going on? She goes, I just need help. I'm like, okay. So I jump in the car, head over to her parents' house. I walk in, her dad's there. Yeah. I said, well, where's, no names. Where is she? And he just got a fucking shit-eating grin on his face. And he points and he goes, she's in the dining room. So I walk in there. She's sitting in the dining room. I said, what's going on? She goes, well, I'm trying to put this puzzle together. And I'm having a hard time. And I look at the table, and there's like, I couldn't even tell you how many pieces around this table. And I look at her, and I'm like, well, what is it supposed to be? So she pulls a box out. She goes, it's supposed to be this rooster. I look at her. I said, all right, girl, put the fucking cornflakes back in the box. We got to go.
He's fucking dying. He can't even.
Okay.
Oh, you just got it.
Yeah. That one took a little bit too long for me.
Dude, that,
I'm kind of embarrassed.
That was
I'm kind
wild.
Of embarrassed over here.
That was wild. Who's the black?
Holy fuck. Yeah,
I
right?
might be. I might be. In the sun,
he
I am.
He said,
yeah, no, that one took
Bailey's rubbing off on you.
Listen, I'm not a huge cereal guy, so I didn't think of the freaking the logo on the box.
Yeah.
But no, that's a good one. That's a good one. I like that.
Fucking beer trivia 39. We got to move on. That was terrible. That was a good one.
Beer trivia!
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. The Basement Bar of Beers and Babble bring to you Beer Trivia!
Beer trivia! All right. First one to raise their hand with the correct answer wins. Where in Michigan can you take a beercation and drink your way across the Beer City Ale Trail? What city?
Gaylord.
No.
Marquette?
No.
Leland?
No. Grand Rapids.
Oh, fuck Grand Rapids.
I didn't know we could take beercations. I'm going to put in for PTO and fucking put that on the shit.
Yeah, that's
I'm going on a beercation, which actually was kind of my last call tonight. I kind of already did that last week. But anyway, beer trivia. Beercation in Grand Rapids, Michigan.
Neat. Grand Rapids, Michigan is beercation.
Yeah.
Wow. Who knew about it? I got to write it down.
Right?
Beercation.
I know. We need to do this. This needs to be a thing.
Yeah, we will. We'll
we're having our own beercation, actually.
Yes, we are.
Yeah,
actually,
coming up on November 27th, the night before Thanksgiving.
Yes.
Where some of our greatest last call stories have ever been made.
Yes.
We're doing a 989 pub crawl We're going to start at the Palace at 7 p.m. and then let the chaos ensue from there. So if you want to hang out with your favorite hosts from either the Wider Range of Conversations or Basement Bar Beers and Babble, Two Cats, One Dog, Crossfaded Sports Network will be there. 989 Pub Crawl, 7 p.m. Wednesday the 27th at the Palace in Essexville.
And please, I really don't want to drive, so someone come in. So one of you guys got to stay sober, please.
We got to get Caleb on the
Actually, yeah, never mind. I'll be in a fucking sick Chevrolet Silverado. Not an RST because he's a piece of shit. But anyway.
I'm just kidding. A real shitty truck?
Yeah, that's what he called it. I have an RST and he goes, oh, you know what that stands for? I'm like, what? He goes, real shitty truck.
No, that's crazy.
It's a rally sport truck, all right? I got sport mode in that hoe. I can go fast, all right?
Rallies. Does it have pregnant chicks in the back? Because that's all that works at rallies. You know, that's kind of a prerequisite to work at rallies.
Oh my God, you have to be pregnant?
Yeah. Have you not noticed that at all the rallies? Like, there's always a pregnant chick. Like, that's always, yeah. It's a whole thing on the Matty Ice and Marky Mark show.
Back in the day. You're sure pregnant, not just taste testers?
Yikes! That was wild.
I would like to be a rally's taste tester. That'd be bomb.
I don't know about it, dude.
Dude, I miss the rally queues. We used to live on those things. They were 50 cent little shitter. They would take all the meat that's about to go bad, and then they would grind it up and make sloppy joes out of this shit and sell them for 50 cents. And so we'd buy 50 of them at a time and then keep them cool and then just eat them throughout the week.
Spend 25 bucks on expired meat.
Yeah, it was fucking great.
That's wild. That's wild.
Yeah.
And another 4,000 on the hospital bill.
Yeah, it's
no shit. Right?
No, you just drink enough beer, it kills the bacteria.
That is. I do like alcohol for that reason.
Speaking of beer.
You need
more? Oh, are you out of beer?
Fucking, let's talk about you.
Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me.
You're stocked up.
Thank you.
Yeah.
You like cruises, right?
I do, very much so.
I love them, too. We just got off of one not too long ago. Nope. But
we're already planning the next one.
I was telling these guys about the one night when I went to went and got a couple of drinks for Donna and I, and then went to the elevator, hit the button, I'm waiting for the elevator. Thing opens up, and there's this black guy, and I've seen him on the ship before. He's in an Amigo and stuff. Mm-hmm. So I'm holding the door open so he can get out. He's the only one in there.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden here it is. Knee poom. Fuck. Knee poom. Fuck. He's going forward and hitting the back of the fucking elevator.
It's like, put it in reverse, Terry.
Yeah. So let I hear this beep, 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 and he starts coming out, runs over my fucking foot. Well, there's a big one. I'm standing up like, son of a bitch. He goes, oh, I'm sorry, I don't have my license yet. So I'm like, okay. So you've been drinking? He goes, no, Ossifer. And takes off. I just stood there laughing my ass off.
He handled that so well. I like that.
He said, I don't give a fuck about you,
to be honest with you.
Yeah.
Thanks for holding the door, asshole.
I'm going to run over your foot and go, fuck you, and leave.
There were this whole group of on the boat of midget. Well, I guess I can't say midget.
Little people.
And funnier, and a lot of them were in their little Amigos too and stuff.
Yeah.
You know, zooming by, it looked like a video game and shit. But little people,
they're out there fucking playing Mario Kart.
LP cart.
But
you should have fucking found some and threw it like a banana.
I was about to say one of them just whips a banana at the other.
No, hold on, you'd
find a turtle from the ocean real quick.
I spoiled my last call, I guess. But no, they're yeah. It was a lot of fun. Met a lot of cool people on there.
That's
already planning my next one.
Yeah, no, that is the best part about cruises to me is. I mean, you fucked up.
You would be hard pressed
to find people on the cruise that are bad people.
Yeah, that are in bad moods.
Because it's like everybody's there for the same exact reason.
Yeah,
we're all here to have the best time. It's like when you go somewhere on land, you know, where you're just going, like, hey, I'm going to Tampa this weekend or I'm going to LA. All those people that you're around, they're living their normal fucking life. So,
yeah.
A lot of them are miserable as fuck.
Unless you catch a Caleb that's watching your kid, because he was like,
that's
"Are you the parent?"
on this one is, we went in October, okay,
yeah,
early October. Figure all the kids are in school.
Mm-hmm.
There's so many fucking kids on there.
Yeah,
yeah.
And
yeah.
I'm like, aren't they supposed to be in school? Well, they're on break. I said,
no, there's no break. The parents don't give a fuck about those.
They were on break.
What break was in October?
That's what I said. And they're like, well, yeah. You know, I said, when do they start? Well, they start end of August. I said, and they're already on break? Well, yeah, they get a fall break.
What the fuck? I would have taken that back in the day.
No nah. shit.
All we did is just didn't go back to class.
No, you know? Literally.
That was our fault break.
Yeah.
I mean, I had breaks, but they weren't sanctioned. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, I wasn't there, but I was supposed to be. Like, Jesus Christ, man.
You know, when I was in school, we got a week off for Christmas, and then we got our spring break.
Yeah, and you're lucky if you get the Thursday of Thanksgiving off.
Yeah. Yeah. Right, the Thursday?
No
yeah.
shit, yeah. Yeah, the Thursday.
Yeah.
The Thanksgiving.
No, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
I know.
They were brutal back in the day, man.
Yeah, I know. Well,
home ec was great because they cooked turkey.
Yeah, right. Fucking, we didn't have that shit. No, they got rid of it. They said, we'll give you a seminar so you have an hour to do whatever the fuck you want.
Well, you guys didn't.
No, they said,
they didn't do a home ec because you guys all fucking ordered DoorDash and shit. You
it
know,
wasn't around.
No,
man.
We didn't.
Dude, DoorDash wasn't around. The person who invented DoorDash was going to school with us, motherfucker.
There's no auto mechanics because,
no, you know what our shit was? We were going to go to Taco Bell and we were still getting them good deals. Now you go to Taco Bell and get a fucking taco and they're like $4.50. You're like, bitch, what?
Yeah.
A taco's 50 cents. If I want a specialty burrito, I'm paying $4.50. But now I want the burrito that fucking cost $1.50, and I want fucking five of them because my parents gave me $10, and I still need to get gas.
Oh, at least your parents gave me money.
Back when I was in high school, you go to Taco Bell, you get ten bucks a month.
Yeah,
you go to Taco Bell, get a six pack for $2.
Yeah,
that's crazy.
Yeah, Taco Bell's on the boycott list at this point.
That's crazy. That's crazy.
I lived off.
Although they brought the tostada back, which I'm fucking grateful for. Yeah, I've already had like 20 of them.
Yeah. How much are those selling a piece now?
How's the mortgage on the home going? Because I know you had to pull one out on that one.
Yeah.
To get those 20 fucking toast. Yeah.
No, they're only $1.99, man.
Oh, are they actually?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So they came back at original price. That's
I don't know about original. Well, no. I think they were still cheaper, but
original price back when I was just got married.
75 cents.
Was 79 cents.
Damn, and I was so close. 4 cents off. Four cents off.
Well, you know, without... Oh, you went over. Yeah, you're right. You fucked up.
Yeah.
No, I lived off of the half-pound beef potato burritos.
Dude, I love those.
They were $2.50.
Those were good, too.
They were $2.50. And so I would just show up at Taco Bell during lunch and be like, you guys got spare change? Anybody have spare change? Yeah. I fucking begged my way through and we'd get one or two burritos.
Do you guys remember, fucking grillers? The grillers were gas.
Those were fire. Do you remember the stacker?
Those were bad.
The original stacker.
The original stacker
$1.29.
Yeah,
I like
for basically a quesadilla.
Yeah, basically.
That's what I get a lot of days. I'll get two stackers.
How much
for
is a quesadilla
$4?
Nowadays? It's like $5 or $6, isn't
it? Oh, 100%.
It's like $7.
Yeah, it's $10
for the meal.
It's a fucking big tortilla that they put meat and cheese in and then fold it and cut it up.
I mean, that's,
put it, saying meat and cheese is very liberal. They put
steak,
a little bit of meat.
Yeah,
right. And cheese.
You get, but I mean, you get at least one chicken strip.
Yeah,
plus slice.
You get a few morsels.
Yeah, I
forget the comedian who pointed it out. I don't know if it was Jim Gaffigan or somebody, but they talk about Mexican food and they're like, it's just tortilla, meat, and cheese. What do you want? Tostada, tortilla, meat, and cheese.
Yep.
Taco, tortilla, meat, and cheese. I want a burrito, tortilla, meat, and cheese sauce.
Enchilada, same deal.
Yeah, except the sauce is on the outside.
I don't know. Exactly. You can find those sneaky item. Like, I think the cheapest thing on their menu is $1.49, and that's a cup of sour cream. And for real, like Taco Bell's just fucking around right now.
Back when the chips and cheese came out, it was 49 cents.
Oh, shit.
Well, they were called nachos back then.
No,
something's going on.
Something's going on with the fucking Essexville fucking Taco Bell. They're, you know those cinnamon twists? They taste like ass. For real, they taste burnt. And then their chips, for some reason, taste like just charcoal. It's fucked up.
Yeah.
I don't know what they're like.
There's no way they're getting making them? Those chips on site.
Well, no. Oh,
hell no.
Yeah, they're pulling them out of a box, but how long that box been made for? You know what I mean?
That's a good point.
Fucking hard. And
it's crazy.
I can tell you with the prices the way they are, they're not moving the way they used to.
Fuck
so,
no.
They're hitting reserves that should have sold at the end of 2019.
I'll go there like 1:30, you know, when that shit used to be damn near to the road.
Oh, yeah, 100%.
I'm the only one there. I'm like, these people spend all their money buying beer and alcohol.
They don't
have enough money to buy your fucking $20 meal for two tacos. You know,
unless you have a bank loan on site.
Yeah,
you know,
we got to pay that robot they got in the drive-thru now.
Yeah.
Dude, I fuck that thing. And why is it blasted to 100% volume?
I know.
Every time it comes on, I'm like, damn.
I know.
I was like, damn.
You could be in the line all the way to the road and order.
One day, I was a little buzzed. And that shit started coming up. I rolled up to the first window, and he goes, hey, do you have, like, an online order or something? I said, no, I want to talk to a fucking human. Robin's over there. Shut up. Stop. Stop. I said, well, that thing, I asked, what do you have on, or, like, what do you guys have to drink that's not carbonated? And the thing said, a Baja Blast? I said,
No,
I'm going to talk to a real person. Do you have fucking lemonade? No. Can I get a fucking lemonade?
He's just at the sign going, operator. Operator, representative.
Like an old 67-year-old woman on the phone. Give me somebody from America, God damn it.
Thank you for calling Taco Bell, Mrs. Susan.
I can't understand you.
That was funny as fuck. This is Susan. You know that's not their damn real names either.
Oh, no, they just have a list of top 50 common white names. Yeah, yeah. Yes, sir. My name is George.
No, I want to try the accent, but I know I'd butcher it. So
no, I promise, sir. My name is George.
Oh, man.
Fucking. So let's get on to Roger's birthday before getting the last call.
Yeah, Roger had another year around the sun.
Yeah, that's right.
He did. And
what are you, 55 now?
41.
41.
I turned 58.
58.
I wrote them a decorated text.
You guys I was like, this dude put this shit through ChatGPT.
No,
he
did.
No way this dude's that funny.
No,
I want to invite people to make it funny.
I did.
Yep. Yeah. I live in Bay City. I want to invite people to a dinner and make it humorous.
This is what I did. So I sent him a text.
And then it spat out this.
It was pretty good.
I sent out a text on Sunday for Roger's birthday on Monday.
Okay.
And it said, Robin and I would like to invite everyone over tomorrow night for Dad's 87th birthday. It said, on the menu is teriyaki chicken and shrimp hibachi cooked by yours truly. And no, I will not have a big hat on. Don't expect any tricks, but I can juggle. It is bring your own beverage. Unless it's water, we can grab a few buckets from the river before dinner, which, if you guys know Bay City, the river's fucking disgusting.
It's kind of like Flint's water.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It honestly might be more, toxic out here. I'm not going to lie.
I said, we will supply your ice for ice cold drinks if you're bringing anything. We have a special dessert going down, too, so bring an empty stomach. We'll see you all at 6:30. Love you all.
Yeah.
And they came over. I cooked them up some hibachi on the Blackstone. The Blackstone was immaculate. Me and Robin scrubbed the fuck out of it on Sunday. It looked so good. It still looks good, by the way. I cleaned it after you guys left.
Good.
But if you have a Blackstone. If you ever cook some shit on there, how gunky it gets, dude.
I'm not gonna lie. I haven't taken the top off mine in about a year and a half.
Oh, you're
right. I could only imagine. What
you should.
It's
you should.
Like
you should let me come over and clean that shit for
the
you.
Squirrels have probably gone in and eat.
Throw me 20
you'd
bucks.
You'd probably be better off just buying a new one.
Yeah, there might be some fucking venom embryo.
No. honestly,
I'm gonna open it and I'm gonna look like.
It's gonna go, Derek.
Yeah. No.
We're gonna take over the world.
No, that's the thing. I'm gonna be in my kitchen through the patio window. I'm gonna start hearing voices. They're gonna be calling me to the goddamn grill.
Listen, it's just
going. It's
going
me. Feed me meat.
This is how it's going to go. I'm going to come over. You're going to throw me a $20 bill. I'll clean your grill, and then we're going to play NCAA for like 7 hours. And then we'll call it a day.
Honestly, that does not sound like a bad deal.
Exactly.
That does not sound
throw
like a bad
deal.
Throw me
20 bucks. I'll bring my own supplies
dessert.
To clean it.
I'll supply the drinks. How about that?
That banana cream pie Robin made. I got to tell you what. That was the first banana cream pie I've ever had.
Really?
That was fucking bomb.
It was.
That was
she
really,
did a good
really
job with it.
She used vanilla wafers and like ground it up. That as the crust. I was like, holy fuck, this is next level fat kid shit. I love this.
Like, I feel like you know a good cream pie.
I've never had one.
Damn. I know you were trying to catch some slip.
I don't know about it. Maybe not banana cream pie.
Hey!
Eddie's been around a cream pie or two.
banana cream pie is my favorite. That was my favorite. And that was real. I ate every fucking speck of it.
Yeah, we sent him home with the pie, and then he was like, 2 days later, he's like, hey, Robin, I have your pie. It's all clean. It's ready to come home. Or like your pie plate. Yeah. And she was like, oh, good. Fuck. Jesus Christ.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. No, it was good. She did a good job with it. She was so scared about it, though, that she had to whisk for like 30 minutes. And you can't like stop when you're making custard. Custard is a very hard thing to make from scratch. And she did it. She did a very good job. I thought it was good. My hibachi skills, I was struggling the whole time. And here I have Eddie, good. Tiffany, and Dad just staring at me. I'm like, fucking help. So, so Eddie's,
well,
I look at Eddie.
I got to tell you, so she doesn't listen, so I can say it. I packed a little cooler full of beer and everything. And I was like, yeah, this would be great.
And then
Tiffany's like, do I need to bring my purse for anything? And I was like, well, yeah, if you need to drive home. And she's like, why the fuck would I need to drive home? And I was like, I don't know if we have a few beers or something. I don't know how long we're going to stay. And she's like, well, I don't want to stay too long. And I was like, all right, fine. I just won't drink. And so I left the cooler on the counter. And so she brings the cooler. And then she's like, you are drinking this beer. And I was like, no, like, I don't want to embarrass you or doing it. And she was like, son of a bitch. So I tried to leave it in the car. And then she brought the cooler in. And the whole time she stared at me like, if you don't fucking open one of these beers, I'm going to be. And so I was just like, no, man, like I'm going to be responsible and fucking stare. So then she's pissed at me. So I was just, that's why I wasn't breaking eye contact with the shrimp.
Yeah. And then I was like, I need a bowl. You're like, got it.
Yeah.
I was like, I need another bowl. You're like, got it.
And it was like 35 degrees outside, but the heat coming off that fucking stair in the room. I was.
Yeah. No, I'm not going to lie. That grill kicks out some heat. Roger was standing right next to it. And I was like, dude, are you cold? And he's like, no, I'm good. We fucking Blackstone's blasting right now.
Oh, yeah.
And
yeah.
Everything going. It was.
Yeah, there's a lot of inefficient. There's a lot of wasted, like. There was just fire underneath that. You know what I mean?
Yeah, because the things are so beneath it. But once that, I mean, that shit didn't cool down until after you guys left. It was still hot when I went out to clean it.
Yeah. The yeah, that's is, what I mean. You must burn through a lot of propane.
Not really. I mean,
oh, but you taught me the trick. Yeah, anybody out there, supply. Anybody out there, if you need fucking propane, go to Tractor Supply and they'll refill the tank for a fraction of the cost of what it is to actually swap it out. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah,
I was like,
I filled 2 20-pounders the other day for, I think it cost me $28 after, or before that night. I paid $28 to get 2 20-pounders filled. 40 pounds of propane for $28.
That's almost 60.
Yeah, or you can go to Menards and exchange 1 20-pounder for $40. So you're spending 80. Yep. I could have spent 80 to get 2 brand-new tanks, or I could use my 2023 and 2024 tank and refill them for $28.
Yeah.
How stupid do you think I am?
Yeah.
Those tanks are going to last forever. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Well, a long time. And apparently Tractor Supply, if you take it there on the right date, you have to ask what date, but they can recertify your tanks if they're not bad.
Oh, yeah. There you go. Yeah. I didn't know Tractor Supply had to be certified.
They do, yes. Oh, because if they're too old, they won't fill them because they have a potential to explode. Yeah.
That makes sense. Well, yeah, then, that's safety.
Yeah. So they can recertify. But she looked at my tanks. She was like, oh, these are great. Like, these are basically brand new.
These are pristine tanks.
Yeah, for real. Yeah, yeah. She was, like, really fucking weird about it. And I was like, can you just fill them? And then
she was
like,
getting all hot and bothered. Yeah. She's like, oh, your tanks.
She's like, I've never seen some tanks like these.
Yeah, right. Hey, listen. Hey, listen.
That's your big fucking tanks.
That's some nice tanks on me, dude. That's all it is. Fucking, I'm
She's
ready.
She's like,
to...
what are you cooking later, bud? What are you
gonna fucking hibachi, bitch. Hey, fucking rice. I'm ready for these last call stories.
Last call for alcohol.
Last call for alcohol.
This is the last call for alcohol this evening. Drink up, drink up, drink up, and order again.
Yeah, we actually have the bell back. That's why forever I've just gone da-dang, dang, da-dang. Because in the very, if any of you have ever listened to on our Patreon, 989.network or patreon.com/989network, the very first episode, it's us going, oh, fuck, the bell's gone. That would be great. I guess da-dang, dang, dang, da-dang. Like, but now it's back. Last call for alcohol. Spencer, kick it off. What do you got?
I think I'm going to talk about... Since it's coming up, I think I'm going to talk about my Thanksgiving trip. From last year. I didn't tell that story yet.
Ooh.
So we get together. Me and Eddie have been trying to.
We've been doing an annual fucking rager.
Let's get fucked up. Yeah. So we always get fucked up on the Wednesday before Thanksgiving. And this year we kind of went a little hard and we met a few friends down on Midland Street. But before then, no, we went straight to Midland Street because I was a little late at work and I got to Midland Street and we started drinking.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
Then we went to Westtown.
We met at Mulligan's for dinner.
Yeah. Well, that's right. Yeah. And Eddie was already fucked up and I was like, fuck it. Let me get a hop slam or whatever. And then I got a hop slam and he got jealous. So I gave him my hop slam. I took his Busch Light. And then we started fucking just tanking him down or whatever. And then we somehow made it over to Midland Street to meet up with like John and Kira and Brandon and all them people. And, we were getting lit at the Rat Skeller. And we got really drunk. And then they were like, let's go to Westtown. And I was like, motherfucker, I'm bald. All right. And I wear a hat every day. Okay.
You can't wear hats.
Yeah. And I can't wear hats in Westtown.
It's but gang, that day, gang stuff.
Yeah.
Whatever they're.
Yeah. Yeah. They don't allow hats in there because the owner hates hats. Apparently, I don't
know. He's got a vendetta.
He can't have baggy jeans and all the whatever. Basically, yeah, he's trying to be like,
you can't look
no
gangster in there.
Yeah.
Where is this?
Westtown. It's right across from Dusso's. Like, it's like right next to the Crown or the old Crown Pub.
When Pete owned O'Hare's, he was the same way. And I DJed.
So, anyway, we went there, and I had forgotten to shave my head that
morning. That's the word, dress
code. Because I normally, like, as a bald head, you need to shave, like, either every day or every other day. You can tell I haven't shaved in a while because I got a little hair going. I look like Ari. I forgot to shave, and I was like, fuck, dude, I'll go in. Fuck it, it's dark in there. So I took my hat off and got to watch some good dancing by your old fucking showcase, Brandon Dixon. And we did that, and then we got out, and we were like, fuck it, let's go to the Shot and Shell. You know where the Shot and Shell is, Derek. You've been around here.
Oh, yeah. Yep,
so it's right by my house right now. So we went to the Shot and Shell, and we were just getting fucking loaded. And we saw a whole bunch of people we knew. And then we're like, fuck it, this is boring. We want to go to the Palace. So we went to the Palace. We had a few more beers. And then we hooked up with Eric, right? And he's the one that drove us back to the Shot. Yeah, because we went to the Shot and Shell. Then we went to the Palace. We got fucked up. I couldn't even see straight. And then Eric was like, well, I want to go to the Palace. And we're like, all right, sweet. The Shot. So we went back to the Shot. I couldn't breathe after that night. But it was so much fun playing pool with people I haven't seen in a long time. Fucking shooting shit with the bartender. I can't even remember his name.
I
can't remember his name. But that was a great time. But then Thanksgiving comes, right? I woke up at the last second, got to my parents' house. We rode out to my Uncle Denny and Aunt Chris's house. The whole night, or the whole day, I am hungover as fuck. Denny forces me to drink like he does every year. He's like, oh, you don't like this? Well, no, it's fine. I'm going to make you this. And then he makes me that. And then I'm just kind of stuck. And then either Roger's making it or I'll make it.
Oh, yeah, you're obliged at this point.
Yeah, you're obliged. And I'm fucking so hungover. And I love my family and everything. I really do. Not my immediate, but just the family I see at Thanksgiving and everything. But so many people wanted to talk to me and ask me about my life. And I just had no answer for them. I was like, my mind scrambled. I'm fucking hungover as shit. I want to eat this food. I want to go home and I want to sleep for 28 and a half hours. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But that's how it is. And then we start coming home. We're getting off of US 10. Let me mind you, I feel like I'm still drunk. I'm not even hungover. I'm just still fucking drunk from the night before. And Hungry Howie's had this sign that says, we got what you need. All right. Mm-hmm. But it's spelled K-N-E-A-D. I didn't know what that meant. So I said, yeah, everyone laughs. Wait, and everyone's like, it's fucking common sense.
What was it? I missed
we
it.
We got what you need.
Oh, yeah, with the K. Need.
Yeah, yeah, it's common sense. I didn't fucking know in the time, all right? And I said, we got what you need. What the fuck is that? And here, my sister, being the bigger woman, need. It's fucking when you need bread, you know? Don't be a fucking idiot. Like, it's common sense. I was like, Roger, stop the fucking car. We're on the highway. We're on the exit of the fucking highway, the freeway. Yeah. Yeah, the one ways. I wanted to get out of the car and beat my sister. I said, square up then, bitch. Listen, I love her to death, but there was no reason for her to give me that much attitude about not knowing what the fuck needing bread was.
Okay.
She said, oh, still bothers me to this day. But that's my last call story. Because that was the last fucking straw.
That was the last call.
Yeah, no shit. She said, it's common sense.
The relationship hasn't been the same since.
No, I love my sister to death. But I will remember that day for the rest of my life when she said that it is common sense to know what needing is. So my firstborn child, that's the first fucking word they'll say.
Yeah, you gotta make
it. Yeah, I said, I want this, I need this, and then there's fucking needing bread. So you need to know the fucking difference because you will not end up like your piece of shit father.
Fucking homophones are hard.
Yeah, it's fucking,
you got to break the cycle.
Yeah. So that's my last call story. We're going to lead right into
Eddie's
half day. You're
going to be
like,
there's a C, and then you see, and then there's fucking, you know, homophones are hard.
I'll just fucking take myself out if I ever see that word again.
Learn Spanish, English language sucks.
Yeah. Everyone I tell that story is, how do you not know what kneading bread is? Well, fuck you too.
All right? You're not a baker.
I'm not a baker.
But you are baked.
So sometimes.
Because I never kneaded it.
Eddie.
Square up right now, partner.
I love you. I love you.
Right pull this car over. Pull this goddamn
that's
car
the
over.
That's the Smeagol difference. And since Derek is an
pull this fucking bar over.
Since Derek is an honorary Smeagol member now, he's allowed to square up with anybody at any time, whenever he wants.
Oh, are we fighting? Do we get
to
fight?
No, we're not fighting. Not fighting.
Like to, I haven't. It's been a while.
I think the only person that wants to fight Derek in this very moment is Randy Smeagol. No, I'm just kidding.
I was going
to
say, Uncle Randy. Come on, brother.
No, Randy. You and him during football games don't get along. You and him after football games get along very well.
Oh, yeah.
So, but he's like, if you sprinkle a little disrespect on Michigan,
That man gets his fucking asshole real tight.
Oh, and let me tell you this. One thing with me in Michigan, there is no sprinkling.
You pour it
the,
on.
The lid is you off. Pour it on. The lid is off. I accidentally dumped the entire fucking jar.
That's right. That is true.
Of pepper on the meal. Yeah. So.
Yep. But that's how you become a real Smeagol. So.
That's how it has to happen.
Yeah. All right, Eddie. Half day, boss. Let's hear it. When you finish drinking. You want to need another one?
I'd have a beer. It's Sunday morning. Oh, yeah. Sorry.
Well, it's Sunday afternoon. No.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Lions. Shit. So, okay. So, it was Friday, and I no, I had a meeting with one of our vendors in the morning, and I got that done, and I was looking at our, I had to reset somebody's Kronos, and then I was like, oh, yeah, I haven't looked at that shit in a while. And I was like, oh, fuck, I still have, like, 50 hours of PTO. And so I asked my boss, I was like, hey, man, I have all my shit done for the week. I was like, can I just go home? And he's like, yeah, I don't care. I was like, fuck yeah. So first thing I did was call Raj. And I was like, hey, I'm getting out early. You want to go to the bar? And he's like, yeah, let me shower, get ready. So, okay. So I fucking come over, pick up Raj. We go to Mulligan's and had some good food. It was, I like, they just got bought out a couple months ago, and the new owners have been doing really well with redoing everything.
That's what I've been hearing, yeah.
Yeah, they haven't gotten to the bathrooms yet. Half the file tile was missing off the wall and everything, but, I mean, it's a process.
One step at a time.
No, I just giving him shit. No, he's a real nice guy. I've met him a couple times. Mulligan's is fucking great. I've always loved it, and I really appreciate that they've kept a lot of the traditional menu items and... excuse me, prices and everything. He hasn't like jacked anything up or done anything, so that's nice.
Sounds like an honorable man.
Yeah, so we're hanging out there, and my plan originally was, well, I have a couple beers, have lunch with Raj, and then I know Tiffany's been wanting to get the Christmas shit up, and so I'll go home, surprise her that I've come home early, and we'll get the Christmas stuff up. Mm. Well, we had 2-3 beers there, and we're like, all right, well, let's head out. And so on the way home, I was like, fuck, you want to stop at the Palace?
I thought he was taking me home. Then.
Yeah. So we pull into the Palace. I was like, ah, why not? Well, I didn't think about it, and I used the joint card. And so I got a text of, why are you not at work? And I was like, I'm bonding with your father. and then, so I was like, well, I'm already in trouble, so in for a penny, in for a fucking pound. So We hung out at the Palace and had a little food there again because it was getting late. And who the fuck shows up but this asshole?
Uh-oh.
Oh, it's so nice. Spencer shows up and Robin and her family. And so we hung out with them for a bit. And, it was really nice to, I played some Keno and stuff. I haven't done that in a long time. It was great to have just that time. And, it's very rare that just Raj and I get together and shoot the shit and, we were having a fucking blast. They were starting to get angry at us because we were getting loud there in Mulligan's. It was fun.
And I was in trouble for being out, too. So Donna was going out with the ladies.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's right.
Friday night.
He's like, yeah, I got to drive
her. I was going to drive her there because I didn't want her driving drunk.
And then she's like, what are you doing? He's like, I'm hammered at the Palace. You're on your own.
So then I'm figured out. But I'm like, I can't leave you. She's not leaving until 7:30, so I can't come home until after 7:30.
Right now, Marty in the doghouse, so might as well commit at this
point.
Well,
that's what I told her. I said, I got to go in and get my electric blanket, take it out to the chicken coop, because that's where I'm sleeping.
Yeah.
I don't want to be cold.
The chickens, yeah.
So then the next day, Tiffany, yesterday, fucking Saturday, Tiffany slept in. By the time she got up, I had taken her car in to get... oil change and alignments and all
this
fucking
control
shit and all this everything. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But I had planned to do it anyway.
Okay.
It just so happened
that. It worked out well.
Like, that worked out. And I brought all the Christmas shit up for her, and I had the lawn guys ended up showing up. And, shout out to fucking Laura's Lawn Care. Laura's Lawn Care and Snow Services, sponsor of the network, one of the longest running sponsors of the network. Chris Lohr came out, and he did... I had him do my lawn and my neighbor's lawns on either side. So he did 3 lawns in 3 hours. Like, he fucking hauled ass, got all the leaves up, mowed everything, trimmed everything. It was fucking wild. Yeah. Yeah, it was real, real, real good service. They're good, good people over there at Laura's Lawn Care Snow Services. Check them out for sure. But yeah, yeah. So I had everything done. So by that night, she's watching football. She'd come over here and watch football. Everything. It was all gravy. It was good. House is clean. Laundry's done. I had fucking half the, well, not half, but some of the Christmas shit up, and so we're all right now.
That's awesome.
But the best part was getting to hang out with Raj. Yeah.
Hell yeah.
It was fun.
That's yeah. awesome.
Derek.
Derek. You got a little last
We don't, yeah, first. And you didn't write anything down.
You know what? It's on the top of the brain. So,
is it? Yeah, get it, girl.
Let's go back to the beginning here. The first
As Grandpa, Great-Grandpa Alphonse always said, if you don't know where to start, go back to the beginning.
Exactly. So this would have been the first time that your boy actually went pretty hard on the Elky, so would say. So,
so you're 16?
First hard 16. Time.
Oh shit! Were you really?
Yeah, no, 100%, 100%. So I was either 15 or 16. We'll go with the 16. I think it makes
sense. Yeah, statute of limitations at this
exactly,
point. You're good.
Exactly. So we're 16. You know, we end up at a little high school party out in the boonies here in Hampton.
Fuck, were you there too?
No.
Oh, but you said oh
for the Derek and the Long Grass. That's the name.
Derek and the Long Grass. That's a good one.
Oh, you know what the story is.
Yes.
Yeah, oh
yeah.
Shit.
Yeah. This is a bit of a notorious story.
This is a friendship known.
Yeah. A coming of age story.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a very Stand By Me. Are you waiting in this?
We end up at this. We end up at this house party out in Hampton. So out in the middle of nowhere, pretty much.
What are them mansions out there?
Yeah. So we end up at this party.
Oh, the one on the Korea house on the corner. Oh, okay.
No.
We showed up a little late, so everyone's kind of already going. And luckily for my degenerate ass, everybody was out around the fire. Probably about 100 yards, 150 yards away from the garage. Me and my boy, we ended up in the garage, and it just so happened that in this garage, we had a fridge, which had a handle of Fireball, as well Ooh. As a handle of UV Blue.
Oh, shit.
So, as I mentioned, this is the first...
It's one of those alcohols I can't drink anymore.
Yeah, both of them.
Do you like UV Blue?
Absolutely not anymore.
Oh, okay.
All right, but back in the day, that shit would gas,
I was
going to
say,
dude.
I have a drink I invented that I give it, but anyway.
When I first started drinking it, loved it, this story ruined it. So
continue.
So we're in the garage, and you know, I'm 16. I haven't really drank at this point. I obviously don't have easy access to alcohol, so... I'm looking at this as a prime opportunity. I'm in the garage. I have free access to these drinks right now.
Yeah.
So we just start going. Me and I won't name names, but me and my boy, we are passing back and forth the bottles. So if I'm holding the Fireball, he's holding the UV Blue. And I would say that I was taking significantly larger drinks. I was kind of going too hard for what I was going to be able to handle. So
you didn't have to drive.
Nope, absolutely not. So I'm just ripping. It's hard to estimate how many shot equivalent I would have taken in them moments. But I would say spitballing at least 12 to 14, if not more. Mind you, 16, never really done this before. So I'm just shooting from the hip. So
I like that term.
And it was probably about a 15-minute period that I intook all of this. I made sure to just take it down. So it hadn't hit yet. So long story short, take all these shots. We walk out of the garage. We walk out to the bonfire where everybody else is.
Yeah.
And at this point, as I'm walking out there, I can already feel it starting to hit. It's hitting down in my chest.
Yeah.
So
it only takes about 15, 20 minutes for liquid to get in your system.
Yeah. So I'm getting the liquid courage at this point. So
love it.
I would say about 75% of the people at this party, I either didn't know or I knew and I didn't like. So,
I know less than half of you half as well as you deserve it. I like less than half of you half as well as I would.
I like that.
Yeah. So it was a interesting like situation, but like I said, the liquid courage is hitting in. So I'm the most confident motherfucker in the room, or not in the room, but in the field right now.
Yes, sir.
So I just go out there. I'm shooting the shit with everybody around the circle here. When I get out there, there's one kid that I don't really know too well, but I know of him. He has a handle of Evan Williams whiskey. So. We're just kind of talking. He takes a shot. He goes, "You want one?" I said, "I'm not going to say no. I can tell you that much." So at this point, I've now drinking.
At that point, the liquor hasn't hit him fully.
Yeah,
it
no,
just,
I've
just
now I've now had about 6 to 7 shots each of both UV Blue and Fireball, and now I'm downing Evan Williams around the fire.
Uh-oh. It's just a cornucopia of awful.
Yeah, so not only am I going way too hard, I'm mixing three different alcohols as a 16-year-old degenerate that has just started drinking heavily for the first time.
I guarantee JT knew exactly what was going to happen at the end of that.
I feel like there had to be some semblance of understanding what was going
to from him to view that. He's like, oh, fuck.
So obviously a lot of this story is kind of in pieces in my head here, but I remember sitting around this fire. And at one point, there was a guy around the fire. His name, I won't say his name, but we'll just call him...
Gary.
Gary. That's a good one. We'll call him Gary. So there were these girls that he had to take home at some point. He had to go drop them off. And then there was two other girls that wanted to go for a ride because, you know, you're fucked up. Fuck it. Let's get in the car. Let's ride.
Yeah.
I jump on the bad wagon. I'm like, hey, I want to go. Fuck yeah. Let's fucking go. Let's get in this car.
I don't know where we're going, but I want
to
go.
Now, a little bit of a background to this. Gary fucking hates me. Gary is not a fan of me as a person.
Awesome.
I am, at this point, getting belligerently drunk. So he, it is safe to say he hates me even more than the normal fucking Tuesday at
just the perfect storm of assholery.
Yeah, so it's perfect. So he immediately is like, fuck no, you're not coming. Because he's the one driving. It's his car. He's like, no, you're not coming. The girls are able to convince him, just let him come. Just let him go. He wants to go. Let him go. So long story short, we end up getting in the car. Now, the way that his car is set up here, he has a back seat, very clearly. There are two doors on the back seat, as a standard build vehicle would have. One of two does not work. It does not open. It does not close.
Good.
If you had to guess where I was seated, it would be... inside the back seat, all the way against this door that does not open or close.
Hell no.
So you're essentially trapped.
I am essentially trapped at this point. So I'm perfect. In the back of this car. We are riding. I remember going to our destination. I do not remember coming back from said destination. But what I do remember coming back from said destination is as we are coming back, we are probably still 10 minutes away from the arrival point. And I am feeling something happen in my stomach.
Uh-oh, the rumblies and the tumblies.
I am feeling the rumblies and the tumblies, so they say. So we're riding back, and I am not feeling fucking great. I'm doing everything in my power to hold in the beast that wants to come out.
You're fucking suppressing Jaeger Hulk.
It gets to a point where I know I'm fucked. I refuse to talk to Gary because I know Gary fucking hates me. And I'm just trying to hold it all in, and I'm trying to black out. I'm already blacked out, but I'm trying to black out what's happening. It gets to a point where there is no more holding the beast. So I'm trying to roll down the window. The window does not work. The window doesn't go down. So I try to open the door, forgetting that the door doesn't open. And this is as we're driving down the road, mind you.
Yeah.
Yep.
Neither option works. I am fucking cooked.
Yep.
I have no idea what to do. I didn't say anything because I couldn't really talk much at this point.
Yeah.
So next thing I know, I wake up and we are at the destination.
I thought you were going to be like, I'm in a field covered in my own spittle. Like,
we're getting there. We are getting there.
Oh, no.
So we are at the destination. I have vomit all down my chest, my stomach, my lap, the back of his seat, the floor of his back seat, everywhere.
Oh.
This was an expungement of what came out of my stomach. And he is pissed. He is fucking pissed.
I get it.
Rightfully. Rightfully. Like I said, this guy already fucking hates me. He wants nothing to do with me. He didn't want me in his car.
Right.
And now he's got a fucking mess.
Yeah, he was correct. Yeah.
So we get there. I'm sitting in the back seat like
now
just
he has
fucking
just cause.
I'm just slumped over in the back seat. I got fucking spit hanging from my mouth. He got everyone out of the car and he's trying to get me out of the car and he's like, "Get the fuck out of my car now." And I'm like, don't worry, man. I'm gonna clean it up. I'm gonna clean this up for you. I'm so sorry. I slide and I literally slid out of the back seat. Like there was no climbing. I just kind of slid my body to the side and kind of squirreled out like a fucking caterpillar.
Yeah.
Rolled onto the ground. Mind you, none of the people in the car were any of my close friends. So once this trip ended, especially as poorly as it did. Everybody else dispersed. They were gone.
Oh, yeah.
Gary is in the house trying to get... Gary's trying to get like paper towels and shit to clean the mess that I've just created. I am alone outside of his car, and I don't know where to go or what to do. And I'll be honest with you, I cannot walk at this point. So I just start crawling. We are in just a huge field. And part of it is like mode and part of it is not. I just keep crawling until I'm in the part of it that is not. So at this point, I'm in 4 foot tall grass, like right on the outside of it. Like I'm right on the edge of it, but I'm in it. And that's, as far as I know, that's where I stayed for about 30 to 45 minutes. And next thing I know, I wake up to headlights kind of right next to my face because somebody that was showing up almost ran me over with their vehicle because I was basically laying where the cars were parking.
Yeah, yeah.
So I wake up to this car, headlights right in my face. What the fuck is going on here? And then they start freaking out because they're like, there's a dude out here. Like, he's not wearing a shirt. He's got fucking vomit hanging from his mouth. Like, so the word starts spreading around the party that, hey, there's something fucking going on out here in the field. My friends get word of this and they automatically know. That's, we've been looking for this motherfucker for a few hours at this point, and this is probably him. So my boy comes up to me. He's trying to help me out. I can't sit up straight. I'm like a newborn baby that has no fucking body control. So I'm trying to roll around. I'm trying to sit up. He brings me water. He's trying to get me water. And I vividly remember trying to take a drink from this water bottle and not a drop of water got in my mouth.
Oh, no.
I'm hovering it above my face and I'm just pouring it down my chest. You know, I was trying to get hydration. It just wasn't working.
See, at that point, I've been that dude before.
Yeah.
And you get hosed off. Like, oh. Especially outside. Like, you just get hosed the fuck down.
I should have like, been. I should have been, yeah. But I wasn't. And I feel bad for my boy.
See, and that's your generation. They don't fucking drink out of hoses anymore.
That's what I'm saying. So, long story short, at this point, you know, I am gone. I am gone. My shirt is dripping wet with a 50% mixture of vomit and water because I couldn't hit my mouth with the water bottle. So I just take it off. I take my shirt off. And mind you, in high school, I'm a big guy. I'm pushing like 300 pounds at this point. So I'm walking around. I got titties out. I got titties out. I got stomach hanging.
Yeah.
And I don't give a fuck because I don't even know where the hell I am. I end up in the passenger seat of my boy's car. He takes me home. He drops me off. I stumble into my house barely. And as soon as I get into my house, I go to take my shoes off. And I lean forward to untie my shoes.
You're gone.
And boom, yep. Smash into the fucking ground.
Yep.
Just absolutely smash. And yeah, that was, it's kind of the end of that story. At that point, I crawled up my stairs again, like a newborn baby just learning how to crawl for the first time. Crawl into bed with what little bit of clothes that I had on remaining and probably spit and fucking puke all over me. And I woke up the next morning, well, the next day at probably about 3 p.m. And I've never felt as shitty as I felt that next day.
That's when you were I know my limit.
But hey, all I can say is this. I got everything out the night before.
Hell yeah.
So, you know, we at least cleared the system. So. Yep.
Fucking A, man. That's some good shit. Rod. Holy shit, Raj.
We got, I wasn't drunk.
I wasn't, wait, that I drunk. Wasn't parentheses that, parentheses drunk. I wasn't
drunk. I'm still going to say I wasn't drunk.
Okay.
But this goes back on the cruise. Another cruise story.
Yes.
That was.
But so we're on the cruise. Well, here comes Saturday. Game day.
Game day.
Game day. You know, and I was drinking, I had a couple of rum and cokes, you know, here and there. But mostly my strawberry daiquiris.
Oh, you know, yeah. Those are good on the ship. Yes, yes.
Oh, I love them. But anyway, so Saturday comes. All right, and we're sailing through Hurricane Oscar.
Nice.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. The fucking hurricane. I forgot about that.
So, you know, Saturday, like, you know, by the pool, outside was, like, closed down, you know, for a couple hours here, and then they'd open it, and then they'd close it down. So, never really got to sit out by the pool Saturday.
Right.
Which is no problem. We woke up, went to breakfast, had our mimosas, and then it was like, nah, shitty weather. We just hit all the bars inside. So that's what I did.
Reasonable.
That's what I did Saturday was all, you know, other than a couple of mimosas in the morning, it was all Bacardi and diet.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know about anybody else, but when I mix Bacardi with Diet Coke, you don't taste the rum. No matter. You don't.
Absolutely.
The Diet Coke somehow cuts the taste.
Yeah.
So these things are going down like fucking water. You know, go to a bar, I have a couple there. Went to another bar, and Donna's, you know, drinking her. She stayed with mimosas for a while, and then she went to her Mick Ultras, and then went to, I can't remember what that, oh, her, the mint things.
Oh, mojitos.
The mojitos.
Oh.
And then, so we're doing that all day because the football game, we didn't play till 7 o'clock at night. Yep. So then we go to the sports bar.
Those late games will get you.
Yeah. So we go to the sports bar. There's a couple of empty bar stools, you know, up the bar. I'm like, shit, we'll just sit here, you know. Well, unfortunately, they couldn't get the Michigan State game on the TV. They had like 75 TVs in this bar. It was awesome. But that wasn't part of their package.
Mm-hmm.
So we're sitting there, and the guy, you know, it was me and then Donna and another lady and another guy. And I sit down, and the guy's like, go green. And he holds his phone up. He's got a Michigan State, you know, cover on his phone. I'm like, oh, cool, you know. So we start talking with him.
A decent soul on this
boat. Yeah, exactly.
Start talking to him. Well, ends up, you know, he graduated from MSU, and his wife graduated from Georgia.
Okay.
So the Georgia-Texas game was on.
Yeah.
You know, on half the screens.
Yeah, half the TVs, yeah.
So she pulls her phone out. Because I'm too. When I'm on a cruise, I don't want fucking. We didn't get the Wi-Fi package.
No, I'm right there with you.
Well, they
that.
Did. So she pulls her phone out. So we're watching Michigan State game on her phone at the bar.
Nice.
And the Georgia. So it was great. And I'm just sucking these fucking things down.
This was. I'm clipping that. Oh, I'm absolutely clipping that sound bite.
Oh,
you're fucked.
This
now.
Is the. This is Michigan State new, Iowa game, right?
No, Michigan State Iowa.
That's
going to
be my new text notification. But, whenever you text me, it's going to go. I've been sucking these fucking things down.
Oh, sucking down these the rum and cokes, Bacardis and diets, and Donna said, you know, I'll you know, the whole time on the ship and stuff, I was drinking my. You know, my strawberry daiquiris.
Yep.
You know, I was fine. Never got drunk. And she goes, you were drunk Saturday. I said, no, I wasn't. And that's where I was not drunk. And she goes, well, you remember Saturday? I'm like, yeah. So I was just like I told you guys, how everything going leading up. She goes, okay. So we're in the bar watching the games. And she goes, do you remember, you know, getting food? And I said, yeah, we got these chicken tenders were fucking awesome in this bar.
Yeah.
They were breaded with crunched with
love.
No, with crunched up cornflakes.
Oh, shit. You can make a puzzle out of those.
Yeah, yeah. So I said, don't drop any. Somebody will try to put it together. But so I said, yeah, we got that. And she goes, do you remember what else? I said, yeah, we got fries. And she goes, what else? I said, we got a veggie tray. You know, the carrots and the celery and the mushrooms and the dip and all that shit. Yeah. She goes, yeah. She goes, do you remember what happened after that? And I'm like, well, we were watching the game. She goes, no. She goes, do you remember George? And George is one of the little people.
Okay, yeah.
I said, I remember George. She goes, do you remember him walking through, going to the casino? I said, no. She goes, Raj, you come walking through, you grabbed a fucking mushroom, threw it across the bar at him, hit him in the head and said, grow, Mario, grow.
No fucking way. Fucking way you did that.
That's what I said.
Are you serious?
I said, no. She goes, you were drunk. I said, no.
No, there's a fucking. There's no way
God.
You did that.
This is slander. This is slander on my name.
Yeah, that's crazy.
You whipped the mushroom across a fucking bar.
Oh my
God.
It's
that girl, Mario Girl.
That's the best thing I've ever heard in my fucking life. Touchdown Lions.
Is that a Lions touchdown?
Yeah, it's Montgomery.
Holy
7-3.
That doesn't help well for your fantasy.
No, I know. But God damn it, Rod. That's crazy.
But I'm still going to say, no, I was not fucking drunk.
No, that's fucking amazing.
Wow. Well, holy fuck.
Shit.
That's how you end a show. Fucking, I got to remember to put that boom, 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 boom fucking sound effect.
No, literally, the one up.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Oh, Mario Grohl. How? No, you weren't drunk. You were just being Raj, man.
Exactly.
That's just a Raj fucking thing to do.
Jesus.
You do that stone cold sober. Oh, that's fucking awesome.
Wow.
Well, I don't know if George would ever listen, but George is a great fucking guy. We
did
got
he
along
laugh?
Great.
Shout out, George. Shout out, George.
I don't fucking know.
I don't know.
I don't remember
he
doing it.
Went, what the fuck was that? Yeah. And just kept going.
I feel like they get enough of jokes on a daily basis that one was probably original enough that he was like, all right, this is actually fun. This is actually a good one.
That is
you motherfucker,
funny.
You actually got me.
Man, thank you guys so much for hanging out with us. Holy fuck. Derek, thank you so much for coming all the way up from St. Charles. We appreciate it.
No, I appreciate it. It's been a fun time.
Appreciate it. Yeah, thank you to Ideal Party Store. I want that kettle corn. Check this out. Friday, November 22nd at 8 p.m. on YouTube. Human Shield is dropping their newest music video. Human Shield, great sponsor of the network. They've been on the show with us, Justin and Angela.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, yeah. They're dropping their new music video this Friday, 8 p.m.
Where can you find that out?
What now?
Where can you find that at?
At YouTube. On YouTube.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And thanks again to Aaron Wiley. And remember the pub crawl, 7 p.m. at Palace in Essexville.
Awesome.
We'll see you guys out there night before Thanksgiving.
Hell yeah.
And as Ernest Hemingway said, always do sober what you said you'd do drunk.
Cheers, guys.
Did you enjoy this episode? Then check out more at 99.network, Mid-Michigan's premier podcast network. Hey, pal. Yeah, yous. Yeah, I see you're looking at that Sports Illustrated for a little bit more than the swimsuits. If you do really like sports, I highly suggest checking out Crossfaded Sports on the 99 Network. These boys are out there spitting all the facts about all the sports. So if you like sports and anything beyond that, and you like drinking and a little bit of that thing, then yeah, I highly suggest Crossfaded Sports on the 99 Network.